Okay, so we're going to be doing something a little bit different today. What we're going to do is look at editing an Excel spreadsheet, like the one on the left that's running in Excel, in Google Sheets. Before we go into too much, I do want to touch on one thing. You see the green rounded rectangle here? That is telling me that that's a new ability for Google Sheets to take an Excel file and leave it in the Excel file format, let you edit it, and then you can download it in the end, still in an Excel file format. So if you go to drive.google.com, the one thing that you do need to do is look in your settings. So go to the gear icon, left click on it, settings, and make sure that the convert uploaded files to Google Docs editor format is turned off. I turned it back on when I was messing around, but this should be unchecked and click done. Otherwise, when you upload it, it will convert the file into the Google Sheets native format, which is fine if you don't plan on downloading it again. If you don't plan on downloading it again, you should convert it because it'll make it easier to work with. But if you need it back down, so if you're just putting it in Sheets to share it with other people and collaborate, so turn that off and upload it. And then when you open it in Google Sheets, you can arrive here. So what we're going to do is we're going to step through the worksheets at the bottom. So this is a template provided by Excel. So I just grabbed it. I started Excel, and this is kind of like a beginner's template to walk you through things. So it has great examples of different things you can do in Excel. So we're going to do them in both places and see what happens. Now it just starts out with adding. So this is a good place to talk about. If you just put a sum formula in here, it's going to work in the desktop version, it's going to work in Google Sheets. So the formulas shouldn't be a big deal. This next spreadsheet is just to show you how autofill works. So if you select the 100, which is a formula, and you hold the left mouse key, drag it down, it's going to autofill that formula into the subsequent cells. We can do that in Google Sheets as well. So far, so good. Let's go to split. I've used Excel since the Ice Age, and I frankly didn't know it could do this, but I'll show you what it means. So if I type Nancy here, it knows that I'm typing that first name, and then it's smart enough to start to autofill. So if I type Andy, it pre-populates it. You can hit enter and go down, and then it did the whole column. So I learned something new today. If I go to the right and I type Nancy, this is in Google Sheets, I type Andy, nothing happens. So you'll lose some of that functionality, some of the built-in overlays in Excel that can make your life a little bit easier. Now there's other ways to do this, obviously, but the point is that you are losing some of the bells and whistles. Go to transpose. This is showing how you can select a row, copy it, left click in the cell, choose paste, and transpose. It'll take that data and it will change it from horizontal to vertical. If I try to do that in Google Sheets, select the data, copy, do paste special, paste transpose. Now we can still do that. We're doing all right. Let's go back to Excel. The sort and filter is going to work in a similar fashion, and actually Excel has recently added sorting and filtering with formulas. So we're pretty comparable there. Tables are operating differently. So when you use one in Excel, if I go into this table and I left click and I say insert table, it asks if this range is the correct range. You can see it put the dancing ants around the right data. So that is right, but the top one is a header and that's checked. Excel has figured that out. So just press OK. So Excel has made this a table, but when Excel makes something a table, it names some of the data in a way that can save time, and it automatically adds these filtering capabilities. So this is what Excel considers a table, and you can work with it in different ways. You can specify entire ranges if you want. If you come over to Google Sheets and you select the data with the tables, so we'll select this right here. You don't have the option to format it as a table. What you can do is format it with alternating colors. And that does pick up the header, and we'll do a green so you can see it look kind of similar. You can customize the colors if you want, but we'll just click done. It does make it look like a table, so that in itself could be helpful, but it does not give it the extra functionality that Excel has. So it didn't automatically give it the filters, and you can't reference this, and it's not automatically called table one like it is in Excel. We won't go into tables too much, but just know that the functionality is much less in Google Sheets. Dropdowns are going to work in a similar way. We can skip over that. That's just data validation. In Excel, when you do some analysis, let's left click and drag down this column. You'll get this extra box that comes up, and when you left click on it, you can do some conditional formatting really quickly, and it kind of guesses which ones that you want. Let's just do a color scale. But in Sheets, you can also do this. So I've selected the same column. Let's go to Format, Conditional Formatting. So it's not quite as easy. You don't have the little shortcut that pops up. You do see this here, but that's a picture that came over from the file. So that doesn't have any functionality. I can click Color Scale, and let's just get one that looks similar. Let's do this. Click Done. That's the same thing. That's conditional formatting and a color scale, and that's happening in Excel as well. Next table has some charts. Chart functionality is similar. It's not exactly the same, so you probably have some compatibility issues, but if you stick with the basics, you should be all right. But one thing to keep in mind, let me close this window, is that goofy things will happen. So when I look at this file that got uploaded, the pictures that are talking about the axis are floating over the chart. Now the chart's still fine. I can just delete those pictures. The data is still here. You still have the functionality of using it. The fonts are different. The legend seems a little bit too small to read, but they basically work. If we look at pivot tables, both Excel and Google Sheets have pretty good pivot table functionality, but you'll see this file that we have here is just a table, but below it is a pivot table, and you can tell when I left click on it, the analyze and the design pivot table options are highlighted and ready to use. If I left click on one of them, you'll see all of the changes that you can make. But if I come over to Google Sheets, come over to the right, the pivot table is gone. The data is still there, but the pivot table went away. You could rebuild it pretty easily. You could go to data, pivot table. We'll say, let's do it on this sheet. And the range is this data here, even though it's behind that. I think I got it. We're going to put it right below. And let's make it kind of similar. So the rows should be the product. The value should be the amount. The color is not exactly right, but that's okay. We'll live with that. Let's close this. And we lost our pivot table here from Excel, but we built a new one. And when we download this in a minute, you'll see that remains intact. And those are the major areas that are available sometimes in Excel, not always in Google Sheets. And the last thing that we want to do is we're going to download this back onto your desktop. I would think the only reason why you'd want to upload it, keep it in Excel format, is if you're going to re-download it, right? Which could be pretty common. Maybe you put it in Google Sheets so that you can use the collaboration features. Maybe you want to share it with someone. When you're done, you want to grab it back down. So we're going to do that. We're going to change the name a little bit. We're going to call it Welcome to Excel, then to Sheets, and back again. We'll just save it as this. Save it. Going to minimize Google Sheets. And now let's open this up as the only file to look at. And we'll take a quick buzz through it. So already you see some things got goofed up a little bit. It's just that the height of the rows came back a little bit goofy. The data that we filled using the autofill is still here. The split isn't here because we didn't do it in Google Sheets. We just showed how Excel does it. The transposition of the data stayed. Sort and filter we didn't do. So if we look at the table and I left click in it, it is a table in Excel because when I left click on it, table tools come up. But some of the same functionality isn't there. So the filtering buttons went away. If I sum one of the columns, though, you can see it is still a table. It called this entire column December. So this table is dynamic, it's labeling that. Otherwise it would have just come through as the range. If we take a look at the charts, I have to scroll down to find them, but they're still there. They're dynamic, they're active. They might look a little bit different, but the data is still intact. And if we come to the pivot table, the one that went away when we uploaded it is still there, just as regular data. We'll delete that poor thing. But the Google Sheets pivot table came through as a pivot table in Excel. And if we want, we can kind of move it back to where we think it belongs. So check out this next video. It's going to show you how to add a custom column of data inside of Pivot Table. Thanks for watching.